हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू youtube.com आवर डॉक्टर वेट चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पीआर पटेल, प्रोफेशनल हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन कैनाइन डिस्टेंपर पार्ट वन। हियर वी विल सी एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पोर्शन ऑफ कैनाइन डिस्टेंपर, क्लिनिकल फाइंडिंग्स एंड वेरियस क्लिनिकल फॉर्म्स ऑफ दिस वायरल डिसीज। फ्रेंड्स, रिमेंबर, canine distemper is very very important disease from all aspects. Friends, first we will see general clinical signs and then we go one by one the symptoms according to system involved or various forms of the disease. Canine distemper is most important disease of dogs, frequently occurring. All age groups of dogs are susceptible and infected. But remember here, young dogs of age group 3 to 6 months are most susceptible and commonly found affected. The case fatality rate is also very high in this young one of 3 to 6 months of age. Remember this age, 3 to 6 month age, because up to 3 months the pups are protected by maternal antibody, colostral antibody. 3 to 6 month the infection is there, or infection is caused, but the immunity developing organs are not properly developed. So immunity is not developed, and second thing, these viruses are causing immunosuppression effect. Then after 6 months, there is sufficient development of the immunity because of the immunoproducing organs are properly developed. There is a high rise of temperature, and characteristic of this disease is biphasic fever or diphasic fever, means two rise of fever during the course of the disease. This is the characteristic, biphasic fever and diphasic fever is the characteristic of this disease. Characteristic fever is biphasic, two peaks or two rise of the temperature in the course of a disease. The body temperature raises up to 103 to 104 degree Fahrenheit. The nose becomes dry because of the high temperature and it is hot. The eyes are severely congested. Marked dullness and depression observed. Animal refused to take food. Anorexia. After few days, there is yellowish green discharge from the eyes and nose. The temperature is usually for few days, 3 to 4 days, and then temperature drops to normal. The temperature is nearly normal till 11th to 12th day of the disease. We continue here the general clinical signs. We have seen that biphasic fever is the characteristic of canine distemper. So first phase of temperature we have seen, then the temperature again shows a second rise. First there is high temperature, 103 to 104 degree Fahrenheit. The temperature remains for 3-4 days, again comes to nearly normal, and it remained up to 11th, 12th day. then again a second rise. So it is called as biphasic. Temperature remains continuous during the course of systemic infection. This canine distemper virus is a systemic infection. Most of the systems of the body are involved. So temperature continues till the course of systemic infection. The systemic infection includes rhinitis, inflammation of the nasal mucosa, and the symptoms of this running nose, purulent discharge, mucopurulent discharge, sneezing, conjunctivitis, severe hyperemia of the conjunctiva, gastroenteritis, inflammation of stomach and intestine, there is diarrhea, and in severe cases, there is dysentery. The feces is loose, may contain blood. Bronchopneumonia manifested by respiratory difficulty, dyspnea, and severe coughing. So most of the systems are involved. So temperature continues for a long time. Clinical recovery take its own time. The clinical manifestations vary according to the severity of the disease and involvement of the system. Here, most of the systems are involved. So there are various forms of the disease and various groups of symptoms according to the system involved. In next slide, we'll see the various clinical forms of the disease. Up till now, we have seen the general clinical signs. Now we go for clinical signs of various forms of disease. The clinical signs of canine distemper depends upon the severity of disease and various systems involved, or the part involved, or the organ involved. So here, according to the system involved, there are certain highlighting symptoms of particular group. And mostly there are five forms of the disease and five types of the symptoms. Pulmonary form, involvement of the lungs, cause pneumonia. Gastrointestinal form, causes gastroenteritis, diarrhea or dysentery, dehydration. Ocular form, conjunctivitis, opacity of cornea. Nervous form are due to neurotropic virus, mostly chronic disease produced nervous form, encephalitis, epileptic form fits, and cutaneous form, that is eruptions, vesicle eruptions and pustular eruptions on skin. So these are the various forms of the disease. One or more forms are also seen along with general signs in canine distemper. So here the clinical symptoms are not fixed. It depends on severity of disease and the organs involved. Here we see the symptoms of pulmonary form. There is coryza-like symptoms. There is oculonasal discharge. First there is serous discharge, then mucoid discharge, mucopurulent and green purulent discharge. There is pharyngitis, difficulty in eating, difficulty in swallowing, coughing. There is bronchitis, difficulty in respiration, dyspnea, and coughing. So coryza-like symptoms. Bronchopneumonia is the common finding in the clinical findings. Bronchopneumonia is very common manifested by coughing and dyspnea. Dear friends, remember, pulmonary form is more prevalent than digestive form. So when you examine the animal, you look for this bronchopneumonia symptom, then digestive system form. Pulmonary form is more common. And you know that pneumonia persists for a long period. So fever also persists for a long period. We see here the clinical signs of gastrointestinal form, involvement of the gastrointestinal tract. There is loss of appetite, vomition. Sometimes vomition may contain blood. Because of gastroenteritis, abdominal pain, the animal become uneasy. The animal frequently sits down, getting up, stretching the abdomen, crying. The feces is semi-solid or very loose, and it is foul smelling. There is diarrhea, and this diarrheic feces may contain blood if the cases are very severe. Hemorrhagic enteritis is very common in pups. Remember this. Bronchopneumonia is very common in pulmonary form. Hemorrhagic enteritis is common in gastrointestinal form. And this leads to dehydration. The third form is the ocular form, where the eyes are involved. The eyelids are swollen, clearly seen from a distance. Congestion of the mucous membranes of conjunctivitis. There is a mucopurulent discharge from the eyes. The pus may cause ulceration of the cornea and opacity of the cornea. There is temporary or transient keratitis, which is manifested by cloudy whiteness of the cornea. The cornea become white. The fourth form is a nervous form. It requires a bit attention. This form is due to neurotropism of the virus. The virus has an affinity to neurons, and it produces classical neurological signs. The classical neurological signs are localized involuntary twitching of a muscle or a group of muscles. Localized means it is totally involved a local part or a local group muscle. It is involuntary. It is not voluntary. There is contraction or twitching of the individual muscle or a group of muscle. And it is manifested by various symptoms such as myoclonus, chorea, flexor spasm, and hyperkinesia. We'll see one by one each clinical manifestation. The main symptom is localized involuntary twitching contraction of a muscle or a group of muscles. Now, what is myoclonus? The myoclonus is a spasmodic jerky contraction of a group of muscle. Spasmodic jerky contraction of a group of muscle. So particular part go on contracting frequently. It is totally involuntary. It is localized. Chorea. Chorea is frequently observed and it is a sequelae of canine distemper. Chorea is a jerky, involuntary movement of affecting various parts of the body. So that various parts of the body looks that they are contracting frequently, involuntary, especially shoulders, hips, and face. Chorea is a common sequelae of the canine distemper. Important. So one, we have seen myoclonus. Second, chorea. In next slide, we will see the other manifestations. Flexor spasm. What is flexor spasm? This spasm causes a limb to bend. The word flexor means bending of the limb. And it causes the leg to move upwards towards the body. Remember here, there is a bending of the leg and contraction such that the leg move upward towards the body. For your information, there is another type, not here, but opposite to flexor type is the extensor spasm, where the limb is held tight and try to extend. The contraction is not upward but downward and moving away from the body. That is the extensor spasm. Here in canine distemper, there is flexor spasm. Another term we have come across is hyperkinesia. Hyper means more, excessive. Kinesia means movement. Excessive, abnormal, involuntary movement is called hyperkinesia. And these symptoms are observed. Myotonus, chorea, flexor spasm, hyperkinesia are the various groups of symptoms and nearly similar, which is commonly observed. For a clinician to know this is very important because it may be confused with the other diseases. And these classical neurosigns appear late in the disease. They are chronic diseases. Convulsions along with salivation is also observed, and characteristic is chewing movement of the jaw, the animal frequently making chewing movements of the jaw, and that is technically called as chewing gum fits. Chewing gum fits, constant chewing movement of the jaw is called as chewing gum fits. The other neurological signs are the animal move in a circle, circling movement, round and round walking. There is bending of the head or tilting of the head, may be mistaken for the rabies or other nervous diseases. There is nystagmus, movement of eyeball frequently, involuntary. Maybe horizontal, maybe vertical, maybe round, round. Rotation of eyeball, nystagmus. When the central nervous system is involved, there may be paresis or paralysis. There is focal generalized seizure. The word focal means the local or focal area of the brain is involved. And in this case, the dog may fall down. There will be coma. And there is epileptic fits, constant convulsion for a few minutes. Again, animal become normal. And again, fits after few hours or few days, depending upon the disease. The muscular spasms and the contractions observed in lips. The lips are continuously moving. Contraction. Cheeks. Jaw movements. contraction of the head, contraction of the neck, or contraction of the limb muscle, then the disease generally progresses and whole body is involved. The eating, drinking is affected, and there may be the death of the animal. Some of the animal manifest nervous symptoms. In that, the condition is chronic distemper encephalitis. A very chronic case is encephalitis occur. And that is called as old dog encephalitis. It is very chronic. Observed in old dog also. In short, it is called ODE, old dog encephalitis. Now, this is observed in fully vaccinated adult dogs without any other systemic canine distemper signs. Again, even after giving vaccination to dog, the fully vaccinated adult dog may show encephalitis. This is a rare form of the canine distemper, but it is occurring. There is difficulty in movement, in coordination of the movement, marked ataxia. Sometimes there is compulsive movement, that animal has to move compulsory. There is force to movement, such as head pressing and continual pacing. The animal makes a continuously movement, walking movement, continual pacing. These all are involuntary. The last one, the fifth form, is a cutaneous form where the skin is involved. This is also frequently occurring and seen in the dog. There is appearance of red rashes, erythema rashes, vesicles and pustules. In many dogs, these are observed. It is called as vesiculopustular eruption. Technically, it is known as distemper exanthema. Appearance of erythematic rash, vesicopustular eruption, is called as distemper exanthema. And these vesicopustular eruptions are observed on the skin of ventral aspect of the abdomen. Remember, clinician, it is important diagnostic symptoms. These eruptions are observed on the ventral aspect of the abdomen and on the skin of inner parts of the thigh. Characteristic. The another cutaneous form observed is hard pad disease. The skin of the foot pad and the nose, it become hard because of hyperkeratitis. So, the pad of the foot become hard, so hard pad disease. Here the foot pad are thickened because of hyperkeratosis, keratitis, and difficulty in walking. An animal manifest lameness symptoms. Friends, canine distemper is very, very important disease, frequently occurring and mostly occurring and most common disease of the dog. I have narrated here all forms and all type of symptoms so that there are no chance of misdiagnosis. Requested to share this important information for dogs, dog owners, for veterinarians, and for you also. Request to subscribe so that the channel flourishes. Thank you very much for observing this video.